Warning, the video you're about to watch is super amazing, so make sure you click the like button below, which really shows your appreciation to the video and the channel. And of course, enjoy the video. Hello guys, this is Greenstorm Tornado X19, your host with the most you can say. not really, but okay. This is episode 7 of my way to play Minecraft. And lately I've been reading these conspiracy theories online TV shows or cartoons and what they were created based off. So I came across a My Little Pony Friendship is Magic conspiracy theory. And what you guys probably don't know, because I didn't mention that this in any other video of mine, is that I am a huge fan of the show, or a brony as you will. So when I read this, struck me with horror. I'm a little shook out from this still. I thought about, you know, this, if this would make it easier for me if I would just pass the word on to you guys who didn't hear this. And you know, you can pass the word on to other people, so yeah, hear me out guys while I read this through, alright? So here we go. You all have probably know about the new generation of My Little Pony Friendship is Magic. It has, for one reason or another, became an overnight sensation. Whether you like the show yourself, you have to admit that its success is impressive. However, it raises a question. Lauren Faust has worked on other popular shows and has been working on her own line of toys, the Galaxy Girls. How did she wind up creating the remake of some 80s toy commercial instead of working on her own show ideas? It could be that she's just nostalgic about her childhood My Little Pony toys or something, but even then, what artist wouldn't rather work on their own ideas? I read this news story a few years ago. It was about 6 girls who all went to the same school and died on the same day, January 18th, 1989. A friend of mine from NC sent me the article from a small local newspaper. I forgot about it until I was watching a few episodes of My Little Pony and realized that the main characters are surprisingly similar to the girls who died. I decided to look for that article again. The paper had either gotten shut down or I had misremembered the name, so I tried tracking down my old World of Warcraft buddy and asked him for the article. Turned out he happened to have files saved on his computer, and I was right. There is a definite connection here. The first girl, named Samantha Gales, was obviously the inspiration for Fluttershy, a shy, introverted girl. What her classmates didn't know was that she was constantly abused at home by her mother and stepfather. Her mother conceived her at the age of 15, and she blamed poor Samantha for ruining her life. This made Samantha self-conscious. Yeah, I mean, remember guys, I'm 15 years old, and I cannot believe that this was happening to a girl as old as me, so yeah, that's pretty horrible. But listen on. When her stepfather moved in, this made the neglect even worse. And her stepfather never liked having to take care of Samantha when her mother was away, so he would lock her in the basement and leave her, sometimes for a whole day. Her mother tolerated this, and as she grew, would hit Samantha for taking out of turn. When her half-sister was born, the abuse became considerably worse. She would be starved, forced to sleep outside, and sometimes beaten outright. because she dressed in shabby clothes and had low self-esteem, she was often picked on by other kids at school. Her only friends were animals she would rescue, which her family would make her get rid of. She committed suicide by overdosing on Valium. So, again, I could not imagine what she must have gotten through. And, yeah, well, she was 15 and she had to hang herself, guys. That's pretty weird. That's pretty horrible, you know. You can imagine what she went through. I can't imagine going through something like this. I mean, I'm so happy I have a family as great as I have, so yeah, but listen on, please. A second, named Janice Walters, was always one of the popular girls. She was rich, smart, and beautiful, and seemed to live the charmed life. However, her parents argued constantly, and were really only together for appearances. She was held up to a high standard, which made her a perfectionist. She wanted to be a designer and live in Paris, but her parents wanted her to remain in Carolina and marry a proper man, one of good breeding and high income. For the most part, her parents ignored her. Her parents' only concern was appearing rich and of high social standing, but in reality, her mother married her father because of money. And since he had accumulated so much debt, they had been losing money fast. This is what got her interested in fashion initially, since she started making her own fashionable clothes to maintain the appearance of wealth. She died in a car crash when her mother and father got into another argument over money while he was driving. Her neck was snapped on impact, and she died instantly, and she was clearly the inspiration for Reality. So I'm guessing she didn't have a horrible family, you know. She had a pretty loving family, but you know, staying together only because of her, you know, made things worse. And if, you know, they say you can't change destiny, but if, you know, they would split apart, the tragic accident wouldn't happen. That's just my opinion, but like I said, you can't really change destiny at all, so. Alright, so then there was Alexandra Matthews. Alex was a competitive girl. She always sought to be the best at the best, especially at sports, track in particular. Let me just step in right here and tell you that I'm a very competitive person as well. I am also very good at sports, as my coach always tells me. But I would never go and cross the line as Alexandra here did. So listen carefully at what happened to her. Her father always wanted a boy, and since her mother was declared incapable of having another child, he decided to raise her as if she was his son. In the end though, she loved her mother and father, and was more than happy to play sports with her father. She excelled at them even. This made her popular, and by the time she was in high school, was being sought out by athletic scouts from colleges all over the country. That made her try even harder. She had always wanted to compete in the Olympics. However, then she was 15, her mother, who had been told she could never have another child, had a son. After that, her parents didn't pay very much attention to her, which made her more determined to succeed. She ended up pushing herself so hard at track, she neglected her friends, her grades, and even her personal health. At one point, she became so desperate, she started taking steroids, which is, again, something I would never do. We at soccer or football, however, if you're an American, you probably say soccer. If you're European, you probably say football. I call football, so... we have a strict policy of so that that steroids are banned, of course, which is great, you know, considering Alexandra's story. But yeah, moving on. What her and her family didn't know was that she had a minor heart condition that the steroids worse. Since she was pushing herself so hard physically as well, she ended up collapsing during a match due to a heart complication. She died in a hospital a few days later. And in the show, Rainbow Dash seems the most similar. Yeah, I see a definite connection here. Although, Rainbow Dash will of course never take steroids, and she probably doesn't know they exist because nonetheless, she is a fairy tale character, and steroids probably don't exist in fairy tales, which is a very good thing, again. And one thing more to say, guys, I am very happy because I'm training at a football club, yeah, with such high quality, and I'm very proud of it that the steroids are strictly forbidden. So. Just one more thing I have to say then. Okay, so moving on to the girl most similar to Applejack, Jamie Sanders, was a farm girl just like the character based off of her. What the show didn't include was that her farm was run down and her family always struggling with money. She oftentimes worked odd jobs under the table to try and help support her family. She had many brothers and sisters and she was the second, which meant it was up to her and her brother to take care of the young ones. This meant she didn't have much time to hang out with her friends or take any extracurricular activities or even do her homework on most nights. She had an aunt or her family from Manhattan was based off who kept offering to send money to support her mother and father. But they were proud and always refused. This is until her father died from a heart attack in 1987. Her mother followed shortly after, having killed herself when she couldn't handle the pressure of taking care of all the children. They were taken in by their senile grandma, who was incapable of truly taking care of them. Jamie herself oftentimes helped out with other family's yard work to keep her family afloat. She died when she fell into a wood chipper. I'm sorry guys, I really have to step in here for just a second with one of my thoughts to say that I'm really glad and really happy with where I am today, with a family and friends that are as supportive as my friends and family are. And I don't know what I would be without you guys, really, I gotta say that. But what I do know is that things are very good for me, I can't lie. I mean, you know, I got a lot of friends, and my family doesn't have, you know, any financial problems, which, so I'm just living a nice life, really, without a problem. And so I value that the most, really, I gotta say. It's a great value. So I hope most of you guys feel the same way and about your life, and you respect every good thing that's happened to you, because these stories that I'm reading are very sad, and it really makes you respect your values again. And so yeah, moving on. Now Pinkie Pie's inspiration probably has the saddest story. Katharine Jackson was a foster child and moved from home to home. Her birth father killed her mother and himself in a fit of rage when she was 5, and she could never quite settle into a good home. Some of the foster families who would take her in were merely interested in the financial support adopting a child would bring, and would refuse to feed or clothe her. Even when she was in a nice home with a good family, the old memories still haunted her, breaking her fragile sanity into a million pieces. She would have nightmares for her mother screaming and bleeding, and her father screaming for her, claiming to be after her next. By the time she was in high school, she completely snapped. She started to hallucinate and act out in class. Many of other kids and even teachers assumed she was merely hyperactive and was trying to be funny. She would oftentimes paint and draw and write about fascinating things and dressed in over-the-top clothing. All the while, her condition was getting worse and worse, the voices and images becoming more realistic and more demanding. She died when she jumped off a building, one of the voices having told her she could fly. What makes the last fact even more chilling is that Lauren originally designed Pinkie Pie to be a Pegasus, as seen in her early development sketches. The last Twilight Sparkle's inspiration was an A student by the name of Cynthia Little. She was held up to a high standard from a young age. Her older brother was always getting awards for academic and athletic achievements, and she was held up to the same high standard. She ended up neglecting other facets of her life in order to make sure she got the best grades. For a while, this worked. Her parents were proud of her accomplishments and bragged to their friends about not having just one genius child, but two. This is until a local private academy for gifted started to become interested in her among several other advanced students. She knew that this would be the best opportunity she could ever have, and so she had to prove herself as a perfect child. But the pressure was high. She knew that there were limited spots for the new students, and she knew that there would be a test and an essay required to get in. So she became a little desperate. She studied to the point where she would hardly eat and never sleep. As the test closed in, she panicked and she opted to find an essay online to copy, and during the test resorted to cheating. When she was caught, her parents were horrified. She sank into a deep depression and eventually hung herself to save herself the shame of being. You might be wondering now why Lauren Faust would be inspired to make a sweet children's show inspired by such depressing events. Perhaps she felt some odd need to give the girls closure, or perhaps to tell their stories in any way she could. Think about it. In one episode named The Cutie Mark Chronicles, each pony describes of how they each earned one cutie marks. Rainbow Dash, who has been able to make a sonic rainboom on the same day for all girls to see and to make them be able to earn their cutie marks, clearly makes you tend to wonder about each girl's death in real life on the same day. And in the show, Fluttershy is able to take care of animals she adores. Rarity is a successful designer with loving parents. Rainbow Dash is in fact a great athlete. Applejack has a successful farm. Pinkie Pie is happy with not a care in the world. And Twilight Sparkle was accepted into an exclusive school. Maybe, just maybe, she wanted to give the spirits of these girls what they always wanted. And I think they're happy. So guys, this is the end for this episode. And these stories make you really think about your life and the values you have to respect in. And so, guys, I'm not asking for likes, I'm not asking for subscriptions this time. I only want you guys to share the video, to your friends and leave a comment in the comment section below saying that you shared this video. And with that, I can promise you only one thing, and that is that that would then make me the happiest YouTuber alive. And now, there's just one more little thing left for me to say, and that is rest in peace Samantha Gales, Janice Walters, Alexandra Matthews, Jamie Sanders, Katharine Jackson, and Cynthia Little. And I can promise you one thing, that if afterlife does exist, when my time comes, I'll be more than happy to find all of you girls there and make friends with all six of you. But until then, look down on us with laughter, joy, and happiness, which most of you didn't have in your life. So I hope you do now, and you found closure.
Between the eyes, it'll right between the